Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching ForgeCraft. Did some changes. The Arcane Boar was definitely not enough to keep up with what I eventually want to do. So, what I've got, you can see here I'm getting all kinds of goodies. And that's because I went ahead and made a quarry and moved to a new location in Digger and set it up. And I've got my... Wow, this thing's almost empty. I'm going to have to redo my... energy input, or output. Energy creation, rather. Because this thing is eating power much, much faster right now than I can provide it. What I had done was... you can't see it from here, but it's... Yeah, let me get rid of you. It was south. Okay. let me get up here quick. Oh, crap. There we go. Alright. I had originally set it up south in a jungle, and that was... Don't set up a quarry in the jungle. Because what's going to happen is... Oh, hello, Mr. Skeleton. What's going to happen is the vines that come down from the trees are just going to regrow. So it's just going to sit there and spin. I probably wasted, 100,000 power before I noticed it. Because I turned it on and went back and did something else and came back and nothing had really happened. And I realized that's what was going on. But, so I came over here, I set it up this high so I could get, hopefully that there would be some copper and some iron and stuff in here, above the water line down at 64. So, yep, we're just burning all our power up. I'm waiting for this thing to run out, and then I'll swap it out for this other energy cell. And then when it runs out, then I'm gonna have to figure out something else to do. And yeah, let's not look at the Enderman. Is this guy still here? I don't know. But yeah, this is what I've been working on trying to get done for the past 3 hours. It's amazing how much time you can burn just trying to do one little thing. This should not have been such an effort. But it was. But now we've got it going. We're getting some serious resource input now. Oh, he is still there. We'll still use the Arcane Boar. Don't worry. But right now it's just going to be a secondary source of resources. And hey, look, we're out. Pull that up. Put another one down. Let it go. So yeah, I'm going to have to seriously increase my power generation to keep up with this. Maybe we'll use a tesseract. Let's see. Tesseract. Energy, unattuned. Lead, okay, that's all relatively easy, and liquid, okay, that's easy enough. Yeah, with liquid ender pearl stuff, I think it works the same way as the redstone. You pulverize the ender pearls, and then put it in the magma crucible and melt it down, and then you can put it into that energy frame and create a tesseract. So we may do that instead. We may hook up another separate energy creation system, separate from the cube system that I've got right now on my sorting machine, because I don't really want to disrupt that. But I am going to need some significant power generation, like 50 Minecraft joules per tick. So that's going to be quite a lot. And the magmatic engine recipe has changed. Now it uses Invar ingots. So I need to make some Invar blend and Let's see, this is recipe iron dust, pulverized iron, and pulverized ferrous metal. Good thing I've got quite a lot of this. I've been saving it. I haven't been turning it into ingots. So I do have plenty of that, and we've got plenty of iron, so I'll be able to do that. And we'll set up a separate power generation system and go from there. So I'm going to let this run out. And you can see we're already 100,000 down just from me putting that down and then talking a bit. So it doesn't last very long, but this thing runs super, super fast. So hopefully we'll start running into some metals here soon. And I made the mistake of putting it on... Well, I guess I didn't. It's wasting some power going back and forth between these things and not actually having a block to break. But that's okay. At least I think it is. It might not be. I mean, it might just not use that at all. I don't know. It might not use power, or maybe it does. Maybe it uses power when it moves. I've never actually seen or heard anything about that, so I don't know. Maybe one of you do. Just let me know. But either way, it's not making that much of a difference. So we're down another 50,000. So I'm going to just let this run, and we'll refill these cubes as best we can and move on. I did some changes. Not sure if I put those on camera or not. Obviously I put the hopper here. It was a pretty good suggestion, and I think it's going to work out pretty well. It'll give me a little bit of extra space. The other thing I did was I put a filter in here to take the cobblestone overflow, as I realized that I was going to need these pulverizers wouldn't keep up with the input of the arcane boar because I wasn't getting a whole lot of ore, so it wasn't using the cobble. And I've got, you know, two stacks of sand in there ready to go anyway, so I needed a place to put the cobble. So this is the filter for it. Why can't I? Or is it a transposer? I don't know. One of them. It's not a filter because I can't get into it. So it must be a transposer. But, it must be a transposer because it goes in through the blue line. If there's no other space in the pulverizers, and it strips the blue color from it, and that just goes straight up, goes over up into here and just straight up into the tube. I've got a restriction tube here, so it won't go back. It won't go back anyway, but this may help out at a later date. So, especially if I fill up all of these, which I seem to be doing at a pretty fast rate. Let me get these out. And those will go straight to the staff, which is pretty cool. And we've already got quite a lot of basic building block resources. All right, so we'll let some more of this fill up. We probably won't get down to anything really super interesting for a while, at least until I have a chance to fill up my energy cells again. But yeah, this one's it's filling up very, very slowly, so we're going to have to do something with that pretty quickly. But in the meantime, we will be back. Okay, we're going to go make a couple of tesseracts and then maybe figure out how to use them. Not sure. Haven't looked at any of this, so we're just kind of going on the fly with it. But right here we've got a couple of tesseract frames, which is 10 hardened glass and diamonds. And I'm pretty sure we're going to need two of them for the transmit and receive. And what I've got here is, this is actually liquid ender, whatever, I don't even know what they're calling it, but you get 250 per ender pearl. So what we're going to do is we're going to put those in there and feed these through one at a time. until we figure out how much we need. And this is losing power because I do have these two hooked up right now. I've got this thing disabled, so it's not going to get rid of the empty cell. But I am going to leave these here for now. Because if I don't, I'll forget, and then I'll go to work tonight, and it won't have a chance to run for 8 hours and fill them back up. Is basically why I'm just going to go ahead and put them on there now and deal with the energy loss that we have. Okay, so it needs one bucket worth of liquid enderpearl. So that's cool. So it takes four of these enderpearls to fill up an energy frame, or a tesseract frame. So we're just going to let that go. And this will dump into here, or not, because it's full. Unattuned tesseract. Alright, let's see. Unattuned tesseract, okay. Very cool. Now, what did I do wrong? Silver! That's what I need. I don't need tin, I need silver. And, you know, it just went into the inventory. That's okay. I'm going to leave this here. We are going to need more of this. We're going to need some more electrum as well. So that will work out just fine. And I will actually need another gold. That's... not thinking clearly. There we go. So we'll go ahead and pulverize those and be ready. We have silver here. We've got a tesseract. Another unattuned. Cool. Good thing we've got a little bit of reserve power. We're going to need it. Oh, I only needed one of each. That's all right. We'll have some for next time. All right, so that's empty. That's empty. Excellent. Electrum. All right, we're going to make the conductance coil. Put that there, two on the bottom, two there, and now we're just waiting for, actually, we should have it, unattuned tesseract, there it is. Energy tesseract, and energy tesseract. Alright, let's put one of these down and see what it looks like, because I think there's going to be an interface with it. Yeah, here we go. Workshop free power, okay. Not going to tap into that. Let's see. Tutorial. Configuration tab. Tune the ender frequency to determine lengths. 0 and 1. Alright. So I guess we'll set a higher number. And we'll make it private. And cool. Okay, so that's how we do that. Easy enough. All right, we'll be back. I think the next thing I'm going to do is start planning out how I'm going to, or where I'm going to put my my extra energy production, my quarry energy production. And I think it'll be over here. And I'll dig this out, and we'll go make some quite a few of the magmatic engines, and probably put another valve down in the tank down here to fuel them. And then we will probably end up using quite a lot of lava after that. But yeah, for now, we're not going to mess with that. I need to figure out exactly what I need, and we'll get to it, though. And I should probably sort this. And, you know, I've got a bunch of this stuff that I need to pull out because I just dumped my inventory in it a while back. So I've got all these minium shards and a bunch of stuff that I really don't need in here. But this is shaping up quite nicely. And let's see, we've still got to... we're still going to expand the house some more. Put another room on there. I'm going to do something with this floor. I've already got a plan for the floor. We'll leave that one, but I've got a plan for this. As soon as this thing works, which I don't believe it, no, it hasn't been updated since the last time I tried it. But we're back down to moderate flux, so we'll probably make some more... Do I have my bucket? I do have my bucket. We'll probably make some more bombcraft stuff here soon. And what I could do is... Plenty of paper. Alright, we've got a theory. And I'm going to run out of seeds. Awesome. Oh, let me see if I have any more. I may be out of flux seeds for now. But, you know what? We've got that big farm down here that I have not touched in a long time. And, oh yeah, I forgot about these too. Got any in there? No, I don't. All this stuff, we haven't even been down here in ages. And yes, I know it's only a 3x3. I don't care. I mean, this is the first time in... I don't even know how many, 20 episodes? No. 12 episodes. We started with 68. This is 82. So, I haven't harvested this flax for ever. So, I don't even need it. Don't need the carrots. I don't need any of this stuff. So... I don't care to expand this right now. So, yes, I know the water extends to 4x4, but I don't care. Crystal capacitor. Interesting. Do we have a thing? No, we don't. We might need... Let's get this. There we go. Got some glass going on. Okay. I wonder if the holding it thing has been fixed. Oh, it has. Good. You have recently started experiencing problems with your Vist supply. Yes, I have. You suspect you might have depleted or mined too much of the local infused ore. No, I have not. You need an artificial way of storing Vist for later use. Cool. Alright, so the last one, let's get these. Put this on cursory and see what we get. That looks like it's going to go. Yep, good thing I've got a bunch of sand and sandstone now. Did I make too much? No, of course not! We've got barrels, we'll just save the extra. 4 stacks, though, that's good. Almost 4. Close enough. Alright, let's go finish up this research. And we'll see what these things do. Discovery crystal capacitor. Excellent. Oh, where's my book? it could be anywhere. I hope it's in here. Nope. Okay, we'll be back when I find it. Happy search feature. Okay. Crystal capacitor. You have found a way of restoring the Vist absorption properties to crystals. By combining 8 of these crystals, you can create a crystal capacitor that functions in much the same way as infused ore. Each one can store up to 100 Vist, and it will slowly absorb or release Vist if nearby nodes are above or below their baseline levels. Interesting. So, I need dull shards, and I have none. And that could be a problem. Because currently these are going to be the most rare to find, unless there's some way to create them that I don't know about. So that could be problematic. Okay, so we're going to have to find some dull shards. And or make them. So if you guys know how to make those things out of regular shards, let me know. Otherwise, we're just going to have to hope we find 8 of them. And it seems like they're a bit rare to get only 100 Vs out of it. So I don't know. But then once we get a couple of those made, we can stick them down in the in Digger somewhere. And just draw off a couple of 300 beasts and then come back here and put it back. And that way we won't have to worry about, we'll be able to mix and match and shift the beasts around and not have to worry about permanently running out here. Which I know a couple of you were worried about, but I don't even do enough Thaumcraft right now to really worry about that. And I don't think anyone else in the area does either. Not in this particular node, anyway. So, okay, very cool. I think we're going to call this an episode. I'm going to have to edit out some of it, so it may be a bit short. If it is, I'm sorry, but, you know, it's some of these are coming in at under 25 minutes lately, and I probably should get a... probably should just start paying attention. See, I did it again. I remember I told you I have a clock on just above my monitor. So every time I look up at the clock, my thumb just kind of automatically moves up, you know, because I might be able to see it better that way. I don't know. Kind of silly, but there it is. Hey, speaking of clocks, let's do this real quick. It's cheap enough. Nope, we need it's still going to be cheap. Relatively cheap. Got a clock. And I need to go get some more leather. Got a clock and an item frame. So let's put that right there. Now I'll always know what time it is. And then I can look up and not have to explain why I'm looking up. If that even changes, that might not... Well, well, it ought to, because this one's animated. So there's no reason... Yeah, see, it did change, the little pixel change there. So it is a functional wall clock now. Excellent. That's pretty cool. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. And we'll see you next time. Oh, one more thing. Two more things, actually. The Spellbound Caves project, Lutz and I are having a hard time getting the time to, you know, to where we can both sit down and spend, you know, 2 or 3 hours on it. It makes it problematic to record those during the week. So we probably won't have any this week. And, I know it's, you know, we'll just put it on hiatus for a little bit, but, yeah, neither of us really had the time to do it this weekend. I was out and about for quite a bit. But, yeah. So, probably no Spellbound Caves. If there is one, it'll be a... will probably have been a fairly easy episode. And, you know, we'll get the wool really quickly. We may go try another section because I know recovering all of our junk from the Nether is going to be an adventure in and of itself. So that's kind of another reason we've been putting it off, just because neither of us has had that much time to do that. But we will continue, and we will be doing other maps. We'll be doing some by Hypixel. He's got a couple of maps that are new to us anyway. That's right, Mr. Garibaldi. He's got a couple of maps that, actually quite a few maps, I believe, that we haven't played yet. And we won't do it on, we'll do it on normal. You know, last time we, Wrath of the Fallen, I picked hard, and that was a pain in the butt. So we'll do it on normal, and just have some fun with it. And we will continue the Spellbound Caves. It's just the logistics of getting us both together for several hours at a time is a little bit more difficult than we had originally thought it might be. But we will continue that. The other thing is, I want to remind you all about my Twitter again. It's SOT Mead, just like my YouTube account. Why is this still running? I swear that just ran. That shouldn't be doing anything. But this thing's been spitting out gravel, like, intermittently for just ever. But it's all full up, so I don't know what's going on. And that's not jammed up. I don't know. Ghost gravel, maybe. Who knows? But yeah, you can, every time I upload a video, it automatically goes to my Twitter. And you don't have to worry, I don't post a lot on Twitter. Yeah, see, there it goes again. Why does it keep making gravel? Is there a bunch of gravel in here? What's going on with that? There it goes again. It's all full up. It should not be making gravel. 64, 64, 64. And it's just popping out gravel. I wonder if that's a duplication bug, because I have got a crap ton of gravel now. Yeah, it's just throwing gravel out. How weird is that? Yeah, it shouldn't be. Or is it doing stone? Is that stone? That might be stone. Why is it doing stone? Why are you... Let's see. Do I have this set to go to white? I shouldn't. Aluminum cinnabar. Okay, that's where it's coming from. It's making stone, not gravel. That is bizarre. Why is cobblestone going in the white tube? Oh, I see. That's why it's going in the white tube. Herpaderp. We forgot a connection, so we're going to do this. Yeah, see, the blue is also going to... Yeah, so it was filling up the... There we go. That should put an end to that. I was wondering why I was getting so much stone. And I just kind of put it out of my head and didn't think about it. But, okay, so we've got 15 stacks of smooth stone now. And you know what? We're going to take you out of here because... We don't need it. There we go. And eventually I will have to... It's only 10% full right now. I've got the extra dimensional upgrades in all of these. But we will have to eventually keep an eye on this, because it will fill up. As I know, I was doing the quarries on the last map, and I had one of these completely full, and another two that were about half full each. So... Yeah, that's going to be a lot of cobble. Okay, I was wondering what was happening with that. Thought I was going insane there for a second. Even more insane. What are we up to on these? Nothing worth worrying about. By the time I get back home tonight, though, they should have all filled up. And, it probably won't even make a dent in all that lava down there. Okay, this time for real, we're going to call it an episode. And I know I said that about 10 minutes ago, but we had some interesting stuff happening. So thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. And check my Twitter. And we'll talk to you all next time. Bye-bye.